Not all severe thunderstorms are created equal, and the National Weather Service is making some changes to their warnings so that we all have a better idea of what's coming. All new at 6, Fox 2 meteorologist Jamie Travers took the Woods Basement System Storm Runner to explain new storm warnings. Jamie?
Yes, well, Sandy, severe storms can be life-threatening, and now there's a clearer picture of what we can expect when a warning is issued, because they're going to be categorized into three tiers based on damage threats. Tier 1, the lowest damage threat, is a base severe thunderstorm warning for winds 60 to 70 miles per hour and hail quarter to ping pong ball sized. Tier 2, considerable severe thunderstorm warnings for 70 to 80 mile per hour winds or hail from golf ball sized to tennis ball sized. And Tier 3, destructive for 80 mile per hour plus winds and hail larger than baseball sized.
These destructive severe thunderstorm warnings now are going to cause all people's cell phones to go off via these wireless emergency alerts, or WEA for short. So if we issue a severe thunderstorm warning with this dangerous level, this 80 mile per hour wind or baseball sized hail or larger, that's going to cause your cell phones to go off to let everyone know that a destructive thunderstorm is on the way.
On average, only 10% of all severe thunderstorms reach the destructive category each year nationwide. But just last year, on August 10th and 11th, we had the costliest storm in U.S. history, the Iowa derecho.
80 to 100 mile per hour winds, even some pockets of 120 mile per hour, just straight line winds, not even a tornado. So it's these kind of thunderstorms that people really need to know about. Even though it's not a tornado, it's doing damage like or even worse than a tornado sometimes.
And with these devastating storms, another way to warn the public could help save lives.
So we are working with local county emergency managers on their siren policies for these new severe destructive thunderstorm warnings. As I mentioned, they will set off your cell phone alerts. So we're working with county emergency managers on if it should sound the sirens as well. So those decisions will be made at the local level, but we are in discussions with them of exactly how that will work.
So just know that moving forward, those tornado sirens may sound, and it might not only mean a tornado, but regardless, you need to take action because it means a potentially life-threatening storm is occurring or is about to move into the area. Reporting live from Maryland Heights outside of the Woods Basement System Storm Runner, meteorologist Jamie Travers, Fox 2 News.